Thank you, Epidemic Sound, for sponsoring this video. So today I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set up a Spotify Now Playing overlay directly inside of OBS Studio. And everything that I mentioned will be in the description of this video. So we'll go ahead and start with going to 6klabs.com. This is going to be the tool that we'll utilize to be able to go ahead and create the actual widget. Once you're here, you'll come to the top right, select login, and then you'll go ahead and get signed in with your Twitch account. So what you'll do is that you'll give authentication access to 6K Labs. And once you do, you'll be brought to a dashboard just like this. So on the left-hand side, we're going to select widgets. You're going to select Amuse. And now here, you're going to see the option to be able to add Spotify or YouTube Music. Now for this video, I'm going to show you how to connect to Spotify. But if you want to go ahead and add YouTube Music, in the description of this video, I'll go ahead and put a link to an article to do just that. Then here for the profile, you have the option to be able to select multiple profiles. And the purpose of utilizing this is if you want different layouts or formats of the actual widget. So for example, if on your gameplay scene, you want to be able to have a vertical version of the actual widget, or on your just chatting, you want to have a horizontal, you can create different styles and use different profiles to connect at the different scenes. So I'm going to leave it at main, and you'll see here where it says OBS setup, please connect your Spotify account. So we'll click that. Now you do not need a Spotify premium account to be able to do this. You can go ahead and lean and use the free plan, which is what I utilize as well. So now we're going to go ahead and click here, learn how to create your app, as we need to get our client ID and our client secret. So once you select this, it's going to bring you to an article on where you need to go. So you want to go ahead and visit the Spotify developer dashboard. Then once you're there, you want to go ahead and create a app. And what we want to do is for the actual name, we want to do Amuse widget. Then for the description, you want to do 6K Labs app. And then for the redirect URI, you want to come back to this article. You want to scroll down and you'll see here is the URI that we want to go ahead and copy. So we'll come back, we'll paste this in here. And then you simply want to select, I understand, after you review the terms and service. And then you simply hit save. Once you hit save, that's going to go ahead and create an app just like this here for you. And what you'll do is that you'll click on the actual app. You'll click on settings, and once you click on settings, it's going to go ahead and bring you here to this screen where you'll see the client ID and your client secret. Now, out of the gate, the client secret is going to be hidden like this. So we'll copy the client ID. We'll come back here to 6K Labs. We'll go ahead and paste that client ID there. We'll come back here and we'll go ahead and copy our client secret. And then once we do that, we simply want to go ahead and hit connect. And now you'll see here that now we have our Spotify account linked. So the first step of this has now been completed. So now we want to come here to where it says widgets. We want to go ahead and click Amuse. And now you'll see here that now we have a link for us to be able to copy for the URL. So we'll go ahead and copy that URL there, and then we'll come back and get it customized. So once you have that clicked, you're going to come back here to OBS Studio. And we're going to go to the scene where you want to be able to add this. So we're going to come here to sources. I'm going to leave it on my gameplay. I'm going to press the plus icon. I'm going to select browser source. I'm going to go ahead and label this Amuse. We'll select okay. And now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and paste that actual link. And then you can leave the width and the height as is. Super important for page permissions that you select this and select read access to user information, current scene collection, and transition. And then you'll simply press OK. Once you do that, you'll see here that it will start to pop up. Just give it a few moments. And now we have this Now Playing overlay. However, nothing is going to be playing. So it says nothing is playing. We need to go ahead and get it access to Spotify to start playing this actual music. Now, when you're using Spotify, before we start customizing, it's super important that you don't utilize music that is going to be copyright or cost you a claim or get your stream muted or your content deleted. This is why I go ahead and utilize Epidemic Sound for my music across all of my content. You are protected. It's royalty free. Doesn't matter whether you play it on Twitch, on TikTok, on YouTube, on Facebook, on Instagram. You are protected, right? So they have over 40,000 original soundtracks and over 90,000 sound effects for you to be able to utilize, right? They have tons of options you can choose from pop, jazz, electric, hip hop, funk, country, rock, right? And what I love the most is the fact that you can go ahead and safe list all your channels. So if you have multiple YouTube channels, you can add them here. If you have your TikTok, your Twitch, your Kick account, your website, your Facebook, your Instagram, meaning that anywhere that you utilize this music, you're going to be protected and you don't have to worry about any kind of copyright issues. Now, once you got ahead and created an account and you'll get a 30-day free trial, I'll put a link in the description of this video. You can come to Spotify, and Epidemic Sound has over 81 playlists for you to be able to select from hip hop to pop to electronic to lo-fi beats to trap to R&B. I mean, the options are literally endless. So once you've gone ahead and decided on what music you want to go ahead and utilize, I'm going to go ahead and select, I'm going to say Latin. So I'll select that there. And now you'll see here that I have the option to be able to play this music. So I'll simply go ahead and hit play. And you'll see here that it begins to play now. Now, if I come back here to OBS, you'll see here that this is now going to go ahead and change here for me. But you have different styles. You can go ahead and decide to choose what you like. So in order to be able to adjust that, we'll come back here. We'll come to 6K Labs. Now you'll see here that you have the options to be able to go ahead and adjust the way this looks. So we can go ahead and select Canvas. I'm going to bring this here to the side. So we have the option here. I'll just turn this down some bit. Okay. So here on the right, we have the option now to select an overlay bar, a gallery, macOS, shell, okay? And you can go ahead and modify this by the canvas, by the vinyl, none. And now once you have this in place, you can go ahead and adjust this exactly how you want. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pause this for the time being. And we'll see here that now we can go ahead and place this exactly where we want it to be. And now that it's in place, you now have the now playing option there. However, just because you have music playing on your stream doesn't mean that it's safe unless you're using a tool and a service like Epidemic Sound. And again, there'll be a link in the description of this video. But if you want to know what music is legally safe to be able to play on stream, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk step by step explaining everything that's available, whether you can play game music, whether you can play music that you got rights to. Watch this video right here to learn more about what music is legally safe to play on stream. I'll see you guys in the next video.